for many years, we worked together on a number of companies, including ING, where I was heading platforms for a couple of years. Today, I would like to discuss with you how to successfully develop and design platforms. It's actually a masterclass on platform design. And actually, my main message for today is your business could be a platform business. And in fact, it probably should be. And if I look at my experience and my clients, which are primarily financial institutions, it's very much the case, right? So it's platforms is a hot topic, but it's certainly not sort of completely embraced. A little bit about myself. So my name is Hugo Rijmakers. I worked in the past for Vodafone, head of digital marketing. I worked 10 years for Philips in several digital innovation roles. Also working a lot on platforms, healthcare platforms, wellness platforms. Worked at ING, global head of innovation management and global head of platforms for retail and SME. And currently I work 2 years as a partner at PA, which is a consultancy firm with around 3,000 people focusing on innovation and transformation. In my former job at ING, I was responsible for setting up ING's global platform strategy, but also rolling out a whole number of initiatives in the market. And essentially what we did is we created the whole engine, the whole innovation engine, the methodology for platforms. We accelerated several value spaces, like housing, like mobility, but also FX and trade. And we were able to launch more than 10 successful startups in the market. And of course, we had a lot of learnings along this journey, because platforms is not easy. It's quite a complex piece of material. But to explain this in a simple way, and I think that that is a good thing. What my experience is so far working with a lot of boards of management is that the term platform is a lot of times really misunderstood. And there is also mostly not a lot of alignment on what it exactly means. And this is actually a very simple explanation. And so it's a platform business model, creates value by facilitating interactions between groups using a common technology platform. And mostly you have, like, on the one side, you have producers, you have consumers, and a platform sort of matches those different needs and interactions. And there is value, which is the result of that. And with platforms, of course, there are a number of special characteristics in relation to other business models. And so it's very much about network effects. It's about control points. And it's also about taking a position in the digital ecosystem. Very scalable and it's very profitable if you do it right. All right. So, of course, everybody in this world in day and age is interacting with platforms ongoingly, right? You have Facebook, you have all of the big platforms, but also small platforms and small scale-ups. And the reason for that is that from a consumer perspective, they actually reduce friction, they lower prices, and sometimes you get a really a lot of good service. And these characteristics, they also count for business world and how businesses interact with each other. Now, of course, I'm telling you nothing new if I'm telling that most of the, so 7-8 of the most valuable companies in the Fortune 500, they're all platforms, right? They have embraced this business model long time ago. For instance, Amazon, you have Twitter, you have Facebook, and they together make more than 5 trillion euros valuation. But now also, a number of years already, of course, there are a lot of benefits also for the banking financial industry. And this is getting more and more traction, is becoming more and more important as financial institutions get commoditized in the market. And for instance, if you take a couple of effects from executive research, you see that 90% of executives believe that cross-industry platforms will become more important to the industry. They say adoption of platforms will positively impact revenues, profitability, and customer satisfaction. And they think that platforms will also help to go beyond banking or going beyond insurance. And this is also what I very much see from my practice, is that financial institutions more and more get into this topic, not only for platformizing their core, but also to look at new value spaces, like, for instance, housing or mobility. And the way to play a role there is to embrace this new platform business model propositions. Now, of course, there are a lot of challenges along the road that banks and financial institutions, they need to take count of. Of course, there is there's regulation on the data. You have GDPR in Europe, which of course limits sometimes the potential of the platform in the market. There is a cultural differences if you start engaging in the ecosystem with other parties, energy companies, whatever, or small startups or scale-ups. There could be a topic of trust and transparency sometimes. And many marketplace opportunities, they have already been taken, right? So it's a development that is really on steroids, right? So you should really start investigating what a platform strategy could mean for your company. And then this counts for a lot of business, but especially for platform. If you want to hire platform talent, data scientist, analytics, innovation is difficult, right? It's very difficult. And therefore, once again, it's a journey that should be explored rapidly. Okay, then you have all of these successful big techs and scale-ups coming up, which sometimes poses the question, what are traditional banks and insurers, do they have a role to play in this development? And I would say yes. So traditional organizations still have a lot of competitive advantage, a strong brand, a large customer base, huge, very valuable data assets, a lot of capital still to move around quickly, global channels, global audiences. What we also see, a lot of core assets which are really valuable to deploy on the platform. And of course, a wide network of partners and suppliers. Now, this is not something that most scale-ups can say, right? Although they have, of course, other interesting things like the mindset and the attitudes to move fast. Well, what I want to do today is to give you a quick preview of a playbook that we are currently working out, and it's actually coming out in January. And it's a playbook that actually addresses the journey that a lot of leaders have starting to explore platforms. And it's the questions that they have is, what should I do for strategy, right? How can I create a powerful strategy for platforms? How would I innovate for platforms? And how would I grow and scale these platforms in market? And what we've done in this playbook is to collect all of our learnings over the last 15 years on platforms and make it into a very pragmatic, easy to use playbook that can be used by business teams to explore quickly what the potential is of a certain idea. It's a unique perspective that we take in this playbook, because it's an end-to-end perspective, right? It's not only innovation, or it's not only implementation, it's not only strategy, it's the whole end-to-end journey. And actually, what that looks like is a little bit like this, right? So it's defining your platform's opportunity, it's designing and validating and building your platform business, and then it's building a scalable business. And there are all kinds of questions in this journey that are important to ask yourself when you start on this journey, and to get proper answers upon. Now, to get those answers, we started to work this out into a number of tools, right? So, for instance, if you think about strategize, you are going to think about what, how to integrate a platform strategy or how to create one. And what we see, and this is a sort of a first minimal viable version of the playbook, what we see is a couple of important questions, right? What new growth areas are suitable for a platform play? What does the growth areas ecosystem look like, and what are your platform opportunities, right? And those questions are important to get an answer upon in the first phase of your strategy. And what that looks like, and I won't go into any detail at the moment, is that there is a number of tools in this journey that that people can use to get a quick understanding of is there any potential for platforms, what is it and how to address it. And then, for instance, finding your growth area is a couple of key questions you need to ask yourself. Who are your consumers and who are your producers? How big is the opportunity in this growth area, looking at a number of elements? And what are your organizational enablers? And think about core assets, capabilities. What are your current initiatives? What kind of unique data do you have, and what kind of strategic direction fit does this have for your company? By filling out these tools, you will get closer to what the strategy can be. Another important tool that we use a lot is platform ecosystem tool. So if you find your growth area, for instance, you're interested in housing, beyond banking, housing space, you need to think and you need to start getting an idea on what are the other key participants in this area, right? What are they specifically doing, and why are they involved into this growth area? And by starting to map out this ecosystem, you get a much better idea on where you stand as a company and what your potential will be going forward. Another tool is finding out what kind of platform opportunities do you actually have, right? And so what are your key target audiences? What kind of services do you want to build on your platform? How do they match on the platform? And what kind of data will you gather on your platform, and how what kind of data will you leverage, can you leverage on the platform? And it's important to find those opportunities because it will determine your success in the end. And for instance, you could think about, hey, I have an opportunity to control a certain domain as a platform orchestrator. Or you could think about, hey, I could be a participant in another platform, right? So getting a grip on these kinds of opportunity is important for your journey going forward. A couple of learnings from this strategize phase, and there are loads of learnings, I must say, but a couple of them I picked out. First of all, it's around awareness. So it's important to teach executive management what platform thinking is, and how it is important to them, and what steps to take, right? We see a lot of sort of misalignment, especially with executive management. You need to know where to grow. It's important to get a good grip on where are the value spaces for you, right? Is it platformizing your core, or is it going into adjacent areas? And it's important because you could fail going into the wrong direction, of course. Then it's defining your role in the ecosystem. And sometimes, and that's what I experienced with ING, for instance, where from a commercial banking perspective, we wanted to go into platforms and FX and trade, but as we were sort of assessing the ecosystem, it appeared that a lot of those positions were already taken, right? And that we were more of a participant in a number of those platforms. And then what I already said, find the right opportunity and spend time on that before you really dive deeper. Okay, so you go from strategy to innovate, right? You find your growth space, you find your ecosystem position, and you have your opportunities, your first opportunities. And then what it is you have to go into experimentation, and experimentation is essentially key for this area. There is a lot of uncertainty with platforms. They're mostly new. They're mostly into new areas with new technologies. So experimentation is actually an essential asset of your way of working. And there are a lot of good practices in the market doing this, but you should never forget that this is an important aspect of bringing platform opportunities to life, right? It's not a first time, right? Definitely not. You need to experiment a lot to make sure that you find that sweet spot in the market, and that you find your, and that you make sure that your network effects are working in the market. And that is a lot of hard work. And if you think about Uber, Amazon, or Alibaba, all of these companies are platform companies, of course, but also all of these companies have this experimentation mindset really at the core of their company, right? Running thousands and thousands of experiments per day. And if I look at the companies where I worked, it's certainly the case that experimentation is something that companies have sometimes difficulty with. The reason for that is that failure, of course, is still something which people are afraid of, and experimentation is, of course, a lot of failure, right? So it's really good to spend time on changing that mindset in your company and make sure that you set yourself up for success. So what kind of innovation tools do we have, right? And I lifted out a number, but we have a lot of tools in this phase. Customer journeys and producer journeys. It's about the value, what kind of value proposition are you building, and what kind of business model is important, and how can you get to the detail of that? Just a couple of tools I lift out and tell a little bit about. For instance, the consumer and producer journey, right? In a platform, you mostly have consumers and producers, just like Uber, you have like drivers, and you have people that want to have a ride, right? Producers and consumers. And you have to make sure, and I think that this is one of the most important things, that you find the need of those audiences, and you validate that need. And next to that, you make sure that you connect the need, that you match the need. And only if you have done these three things, you will have a successful platform. And this tool essentially helps you to do this. Another tool is value proposition, right? You need to have a value proposition for your platform, right? Which is all about creating that mission and creating a value proposition for the consumer side and for the producer side. And why is it two value propositions, you might ask yourself? Of course, again, if you look at a simple example like Uber, they have a proposition for people that want to find a ride quickly, and they have a proposition for taxi drivers that just want to make some extra money. So, and this is why you have a split up between those two value propositions. And this tool helps you with articulating those value propositions, but also looking at what kind of key reasons to believe are there per value proposition. Business model, this looks a little bit more complex. probably is because here we actually bring together all of the key elements of the platform business model, which where you have on the left side consumers, the right side producers, in the middle yourself potentially as a platform owner, and on the bottom you have the revenue streams, you have the partners and the cost structure and the resources that you need, right? And by filling this in, you get a pretty good 360 perspective on what it is, what your platform business model is about, and where you need more info, and how you can make it more successful. Some key learnings. You have to find real problems, and this is not so easy, right? Because this is a step that mostly is skipped or not done right. I also must say is that with platforms you have consumers and producers. That is normally not the case. Normally you have a client and you have a company. So validating the consumers and the producers parallel to each other sometimes is hard for new people that start to develop platforms. And then of course you need to find the match. What is the core interaction on the platform that matches those different need sets? Also something that is being viewed as not easy. Designing your business model, well, this is something that you should start with at an early stage in time in developing your platform business model to make sure that you always keep track of what how you develop this business model, because you will have a lot of insights on this journey going forward. And then the last thing is design your control points. So how can you make sure that the platform becomes really sticky, right? How can you make sure that it becomes sticky from a producer point of view and from a consumer point of view? And just to give a quick example, for instance, Fitbit, what is their control point? Their control point is their health data, right? It makes sure that you come back every time to the surface to look at your progression per day, and make sure that you you reap the value of that. And of course, this can be different for any other platform, but it's important to keep track on what makes this platform sticky. And mostly it's data that makes it interesting for parties to engage with the platform. Then we go to the last phase of this method, which is actually grow. It's all about scaling. And also here we picked out like three different tools, different elements. It's the platform operating model. And what does this look like? It's platform strategy. And so how do you create a powerful strategy to sustain growth? And it's about network effects. How do you design and use network effects to further scale your platform? And these three things are also very important, especially in the phase where you, when you start scaling and growing your platform. So a little bit about the platform operating model. So if you get to the point of developing your team, your technology stack, it's a lot of things that might be different, right? You need to know what kind of skills, competences do I need? What kind of data sources do I need? How do I get them? What kind of applications and technologies do you need? Infrastructure, what about the culture? Is that the right culture? How do we influence it? So there's a lot of these elements in your operating model that will be different, right? And it's good to get a clear picture on what that is and how you can influence it and how you can roadmap these elements. And of course, by no means this is solving your problem, this tool, but it gives you already a very clear understanding and a discussion with your peers and with specialists. Platform strategy tool. So this is sometimes also a little bit an area where there is not sufficient ideas in corporations and companies. So what is your data strategy? What kind of data goals do you have? What would be your vision for your data? And how would you bring together unique data from an internal, external and open data point of view? And what kind of capabilities would you need in order to drive data successfully through your platform and make sure that you are prepared for this. So this is all about the data tool, data strategy tool. And network effects, of course, this is something which is a pivotal element of platforms. It will definitely determine your success and the way how you can exponentially grow your platform in the market, in the ecosystem. And this is something that you will of course start with earlier in your platform journey, but definitely you need to drive this regularly and monitor it and review it when you have your platform in the market and you launch your first MVP. And these kinds of tools help you to focus on the right elements and to also experiment with network effects. So and this actually brings me to some other learnings that we have had so far. So focus on skills. It's what I already said. It's important to get a grip on what are the right people in the company. How do you grow people? How do you develop them? How do you recruit people that are important to bring this to the next level? And sometimes also it's how can you acquire companies that will add to this base of skills and resources. So designing this new architecture, it's a lot of new architecture in my experience. It's open cloud-based software, which of course not always aligns well with the current IT infrastructure, and therefore it needs a lot of attention and needs to be rigorously reviewed to make sure that it's gonna be successful. Then it's about data. I cannot say it more. Data is an important asset in your platform. You need to make sure that you have the right compelling competitive data. And you need to make sure that you can aggregate the data and that you can also make sure that you valorize the data in your platform. And this needs also attention and a lot of attention. And then what I already said, network effects. It's important to keep on paying a lot of attention to this because this is what will bring your platform to the next level and which will boost it in the market. Well, question is, are you ready to start your platform business journey? I hope that I have been able to give you at least some perspectives, some simple perspectives on what it takes to design, develop and launch a platform. These kinds of tools and insights, they might help you. I would say don't hesitate to reach out and maybe get a first copy of one of those platform playbooks that we have. Very willing to share this kind of knowledge, very passionate about this topic. Open for any questions that might arise. Sorry?
So I need to go to the questions.
Thank you.
Hi, Hugo.
Hey, hello.
Yeah, thank you for speaking. The session has ended, so yeah. Anyone want to say anything?
Oh, good.
Oh, it's good.
Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Time to sleep.
Time to sleep.
Thank you.
For sure. Yes, time to sleep. Okay, thank you very much.
So much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.